Hello and welcome to the session in which we would look at the present value of an annuity. This topic is related obviously to the present value of a single amount. In other words, if you don't understand the present value of a single amount, I strongly suggest you take a look at the prerequisite, because if you don't understand how to compute the single amount, you will find difficulty understanding the present value of an annuity. Also, based on the prerequisite session, you need to understand the difference between simple and compounding interest. The present value of an annuity is an extremely important topic for accounting students, whether you are dealing with bonds, leases, notes payable. You have to understand how the present value of an annuity works. So it's critical for your success also as an accounting student. Whether you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate, I strongly suggest you take a look at my website, farhadlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. You keep it. I am a useful addition. I explain the material differently. I show you the theory behind the concept. I go a little bit more in details than your CPA review course. You keep your CPA review course. It's going to help you understand it better. Your risk is 1 month of subscription. Your potential gain is adding 10 to 15 points to your exam and passing the exam. I do have resources for other college accounting courses as well, and my CPA supplemental resources are aligned with your Roger, Wiley, Becker, Gleam, so it's very easy to go back and forth between my CPA review courses, my CPA supplemental review courses, and your CPA review course. Please take a look also at my website for the AI CPA supplemental questions. These are all the AI CPA previously released questions, which is approximately 1,400 of them with detailed solution. If you haven't connected with me on LinkedIn, please do so. Take a look at my LinkedIn recommendation, like this recording, share it with others, connect with me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Reddit. So let's talk about the present value of an annuity. And what is an annuity? Because the assumption here is you know how to compute the present value of a single amount. So we're gonna change the single to an annuity. An annuity is a periodic payment or receipt of the same amount of money at the same interval. So basically, we are looking at an interval. Let's assume this is year 1, 2, 3, 4. You are either paying or receiving the same amount of money at the same interval. This is what an annuity is. And all we're going to try to do is to find the present value of the annuity, which is what? Which is discounting those payment to the present value. This is what the present value of an annuity. It's a discounting process to find what's the value of those series payment giving a certain interest rate. Now we're going to have two type of annuities. We're going to have present value of an ordinary annuity, and as I just showed you, year 1, 2, 3, 4, basically the payments or the receipts will start at the end of the first period or at the end of the first year. And we have the present value of an annuity due. And we dealt with the same concept with the future value. And the present value of an annuity due, the first payment or the first receipt will start today. So we would still have 1, 2, 3, 4 payments, but one of the payment, it's either received earlier or paid earlier. So we have to deal with both, starting with the present value of an ordinary annuity. And the best way to illustrate this is just to work an example to show you the concept. How much will you pay for an investment that will pay you $10,000 for 5 years, assuming you want to earn 5% interest? So this is 5 years. So I define the period as five years. So the question is, here we go. I'm offering you an investment, and I'm telling you, here's what's going to happen. I'm going to pay you $10,000, $10,000, $10,000, $10,000, and another $10,000. So those 5,000s in the next 5 years. How much will you pay for this investment? How much is this investment worth? That's the question to you. How much is it worth? Well, if you want to earn 5%, it means I want to earn 5% on my money. So I have to discount those investments. In each one of them, it has to earn 5%. Well, guess what? I can do that. I can go to the present value table that we learned about, and I can discount the 10,000 separately, the second 10,000 separately, the third, the fourth, and the fifth. And I can do that. Let me show you how I will discount them. The first 10,000 I'm going to be receiving, which is going to be a year from now, if I'm earning 5% a year from now, I'm going to discount it at 0.95238 or 0.952. It doesn't matter. This is rounding. So I will pay for that $9,523. For the second, $10,000, I'm willing to pay 0.907, 9073. 10,000 times 0.9073 will give us 9,000. I'm willing to pay for that second $10,000, $9,070. For the third 10,000, I'm willing to pay 0.86384 or rounding 0.864. I'm willing to pay $8,634.40. And the fourth payment, I'm willing to pay 0.823. And the fifth payment, I'm willing to pay 0.784. So notice what I did. I discounted those payments individually, like if it's a single payment. But what do we know about this series of payment? It looks like an annuity. It's the same payment every time. And guess what? If I add all those single factors, they're going to give me 4.3295. And this is the present value of the annuity factor. So simply put, if I take $10,000 multiplied by this factor, 4.3295, I will find out that the present value of this series of payment is $43,294. Now, simply put, if I want to compute this 4.3925, this is the formula, the present value factor of an ordinary annuity. I just have to compute this formula, which is 1 minus 1 divided by 1 plus I raised to the number of periods, which is 5, and divided by I. Then what I would do is I will take my payment times what I found in this formula to find the present value of the annuity. This is the long way. This is if you want to do it manually. The good thing about your accounting course or your finance course, you might be using a calculator, which I don't show you the calculator here. I show you how to use the tables. To using the tables, you'll go to the present value of the annuity table. This is ordinary annuity. Ordinary annuity, make sure you are dealing with a proper table, present value of an ordinary annuity, and it's 5 years, so the period is 5, and the interest rate is 5%, and they cross at 4.3295, and this is the 4.3295. We find the present value of the annuity, so rather than going through the computation, those factors will be giving to you. And if you really want to prove this, that this is what would happen, well, we're going to invest $43,295 today, give it to someone, to an investor. This money is going to grow at 5%, and it's going to accumulate to $45,459.54 after a year. We're going to take out $1,000. What's left is $35,459.54. I'm going to round it. So this is going to be $35,460 at the beginning of the second year. It's going to earn 5%, and the amount will be $37,232.52. I'm going to take out $10,000. I'm going to be remaining balance is $27,232.52. And if you keep going by year five, you should have zero. This it says 4 pennies. It's a rounding, but you will have zero. So indeed, if you invest $43,295, let it grow at 5%, taking $10,000 out, you will earn exactly 5% on this investment. Let's take a look at another example. What is the present value obligation? What's the present value obligation? This is basically we're looking to find the value of an obligation. You have to pay a 5 annual payment of $6,000 paid at the end of the period given 6% interest rate. So here we go. We have an obligation to pay $6,000. Rather than receiving, we're going to be paying. So we have an obligation, $6,000. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And another $6,006. Okay. And the interest rate we're going to be charged is 6%. So this is basically, we can say what's the value of this or what's the obligation because we are discounting payment. So we have an obligation. It doesn't matter. The point is you have to discount those $6,000 back to the present value. How do we do so? Well, we just learned we can go to the tables and we have 5 annual payments. So 5 is the N. And we are earnings, we have to pay 6%. So the factor is 4.2124. So if we'll take 6,000 times 4.2124, we record the obligation at 25,274. And we have to pay it back in $6,000 increment. And let me show you the proof. If we start with 25,274, we're going to be charged interest 6%. It's going to accumulate to 26,790. We're going to pay 6,000, and we're going to, the remaining balance will be 20,791, rounding 791. Well, that's, we're going to be charged 6%. The balance will be $22,038.32. We're going to pay 6,000 again. The balance will go down to $16,038. Then the $16,038 will increase at 6%. The balance will be $17,061. We're going to pay off 6,000, so on and so forth. By the fifth year, by the end of the fifth year, we'll pay off this loan again. The 29 pennies is a rounding issue. Now let's talk about the present value of an annuity due. Well, as I told you, the difference is you're going to start either to receive a payment earlier, or you're going to pay the first payment immediately today, which is a payment earlier. Okay, so payment or receipt is starting today. So you're going to have one fewer period to discount. Okay, so the cash flow comes one period sooner if you're receiving the money, and the cash payment will come one period sooner. So to find the present value of an annuity due, most textbook, they do have this table, but sometimes they don't have the table. Okay, so what you do is you'll take the present value factor of an ordinary annuity, what you learn in the prior, on the prior slide, you multiply it by 1 plus I. So if it's not giving, you can find it. Okay, so it's the present value obligation of 5 annual payment of 6,000, giving 6% interest rate starting today, not staring, starting today. And here's what's going to happen. We're going to find the factor. This is for an ordinary annuity. So this table is ordinary annuity, because I'm going to assume your textbook don't provide an annuity due. So you'll take your ordinary annuity, which is, we already figured it out, 6%, 6 period, 4.214, and you multiply it by 1.06, so the present value of the annuity due, the present value factor of the annuity due is 4.651. Therefore, you would record the obligation initially at 26,790.86. And annuity due, you will see it later on when you are dealing with leases, with the chapter of leases, because the first payment of the lease is usually due immediately. Now, we're going to have to find sometime the interest rate in an annuity situation. Okay, so it will be something like this. Assume that you own $527.28.77 on your Visa card. The lender offer you 12 equal monthly payments of $50 to pay off the balance. What interest rate is the lender charging you? So here we're looking for I. Well, let's look at it from a present value annuity problem. The present value of the annuity equal to the payment times the present value factor of the ordinary annuity. We know, what do we know? We know the, well, let's look at the numbers. We know the present value of the obligation right now, 528.77. $50 is the payment. We have to multiply it by the present value of an ordinary annuity, and this is how we find 528.77. So we have everything except the factor. Can we find the factor? Sure we can. We are told, you have to be careful here, you are told that the payments are monthly payments. Okay, so it's 12 monthly payments, therefore the period equal to 12. Okay, and we are dealing with a $50 payment. So if we have to find the factor, we have to go through the computation. 528 divided by 50, the factor is 10.575. Now, dealing with 12 periods, we're going to go across and find the closest thing to this factor. So the closest thing to this factor is 10.573. It's right here. Therefore, we imply that the interest rate we are being charged is 2%. So you are being charged 2% on this loan, and this is a monthly rate. Remember, the monthly, you can convert it into, you know, this is the nominal rate, 2%. So monthly 2 is 24%. They're going to quote you 24%, and the 24%, you know, if it's compounded monthly, you have to find the effective rate, because this is the nominal rate. Okay, so it's 2% monthly, and this is the proof that this will happen. So if you have rounding $529, you are being charged 2%. At the end of the first month, your balance will accumulate to $539.35. You're going to pay $50. The remaining balance is $489.35. then this amount for $89.35, it's going to accumulate at 2%. It's going to end up to be $499.13. You're going to pay $50. The balance will go down to $449.13, so on and so forth. And if you do this for 12 months, you will pay off the balance after 12 months. You really don't want to do that because that's a very expensive credit card balance. But the point is to show you that if you do pay $50 and the interest rate that we computed 2%, you will be able to pay off your loan. Sometimes you have to find the payment. So how do you find the payment in an annuity problem? Let's assume Marsha and Homer have saved $36,000 to finance Lisa's four-year education in a local bank earning 4%. So they have $36,000, they're going to invest it at 4%. What amount can Lisa take out every 6 months during her four-year college year? So basically what we're looking for is what's the payment? What payment can Lisa afford every 6 months? So remember, the period is semi-annually, every 6 months. So let's take a look at our general formula. The present value of an ordinary annuity equal to the payment times the present value factor of an ordinary annuity. So let's see what we have. What we have here is the following. We have $36,000, the present value of an ordinary annuity. We don't know the payment. We know the factors are 7.325. How did we find the factors? Well, if it's a four-year times 2 is 8. So the period we are dealing with is 8. And we have to find the factor at 4%. But remember, 4%, that's annual rate. It's this is semi-annually. Therefore, we have to look at 2. And we find the factor is 7.3255. So 36,000, which is the present value of the annuity, equal to the payment, which is we don't know the payment, times the factor should equal 36. Well, if we solve for the payment, we see that the payment is approximately 4,914. So Lisa can withdraw 4,914 when she attended her school. So basically something like this. So every 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Lisa can withdraw this amount every period. Okay? If Marsh and Homer can put that money in an account earning 36,000, earning 2% semi-annually. And this is the proof for it. So they start, they deposit the money, 36,000, they earn 2%. That money will accumulate to 36,720. Lisa would withdraw this balance, $4,935. What's left in the balance? 36,805.65. This amount, 31,805.65, will earn 2%. The balance will become at the end of the year 32,441.76. Lisa will withdraw 4,914. The balance will become 27,527. And if we go like this for the next 4 years, the withdrawal every 6 months, we'll have 2 pennies in the account, which is technically zero. This is a rounding issue. So here you see also that you can prove it. The best way to learn the present value is to kind of just see if you can, see if you understand it. And if you understand it, you should be able to do it in an Excel sheet real easily. At the end of this recording, I cannot emphasize the importance of the present value of a single amount and the present value of an annuity. It's extremely important understanding this discount process, whether you are an accounting student, a finance student, and especially if you are a CPA candidate. If you are a candidate, I don't replace your CPA review course. You keep it. I am a useful addition. I explain the material differently so you can take advantage of your review course to prepare for fully for the exam. Studying for the exam is a one-time investment in your life. Take it seriously. The CPA exam is worth it. Good luck, study hard, and of course, stay safe.